Okay. You ever make a friend you regret making? You know the ones, the kind that talk bad about you behind your back, or the kind that always stole your Yu-Gi-Oh cards when you were a kid, or even the kind that fat-shamed you in middle school. Karen? Don't think I've forgotten what you said about my school picture being too fat to fit in the yearbook. You're fine just the way you are. Okay, maybe that one was a little bit too specific, but you get what I'm talking about. Those kinds of friends that give you that sinking feeling in your chest whenever they're around, like you don't even really know why you're still friends. Maybe it's just been so long and you feel like you're too invested to just say no and cut them out. Well, whatever the reason for keeping them, I had a crazy one. One so crazy that honestly I still can't believe we stayed friends after all the things he did to me. Now, did he talk bad about me behind his back? No. Did he steal my Yu-Gi-Oh cards? Well, yeah, but he also did something much worse. Much, much worse. This kid robbed my house. Or at least, I'm pretty darn sure he did, and I'm gonna prove it. Ready? Let's begin with some background. I was in the fourth grade, before my fat years, and we had just moved to a small little town in some backwoods, middle of nowhere, hillbilly center of the South. So, you know, just about 5 minutes away from the nearest metropolis. Into a house straight out of a Goosebumps books. I'm talking middle of an eerie forest, had a nearby swamp that was probably radioactive from government experiments, had secret rooms and passageways, and complete with creepy neighbors that always stared you down like they were judging whether or not you'd survive the upcoming rapture. They were actually pretty nice people. The works, you know? It was kind of the worst, and moving in wasn't so great either. Now let me tell you something about my family. We don't believe in paying for help. Did we hire a moving company to help move all of our stuff? Heck no. We got the old reliable U-Haul truck and moved everything ourselves. We were so cheap, we didn't even get a normal sized one. Instead, we chose the smallest one, meaning we had to take multiple trips back and forth between houses like crazy people. Now, why am I telling you all this and what does any have to do with the robbery? Nothing. I just want to vent, okay? But anyway, we eventually, without any help, got settled into our new creepy neighborhood. Except we didn't really unpack since we had a huge family trip back to the motherland right after we moved in. Now I know what you're thinking. Moving into a new neighborhood and then leaving the house empty for a few months seems like a terrible idea. But don't you worry, as my dad had a downright genius plan. Whatcha doing? I'm moving everything valuable into the house. Why? Because if someone breaks in, they'll break into the shed. Why? Because people like easy targets. Why? Ask your mother. Okay, so you're saying no one's gonna break into the house, right? Right. We got robbed! Yep, that's right. All our stuff gone. The house was trashed. There was stuff thrown about everywhere. They even dug out some of the walls looking for, I don't know, I guess, wall money? But you want to know what area of the house that wasn't broken into? Yeah, that's right. The shed. Left completely alone, the lock wasn't even messed with. So, yeah, thanks, Dad. What made it even worse was that we didn't just rely on locks to stop potential burglaries. Oh no, we thought we had it all figured out when we also asked one of our family friends if they could house sit for us. But you know, they live kind of far away. So for 3 months, they only visited the house a few times a month. Which, okay, can we talk about that? If you're gonna agree to house sit, don't just stop by whenever you got time. Game Boys and TVs are on the line here, man. Oh, and I guess priceless family heirlooms or something. I don't know. So anyway, after crying about losing my Game Boy for a solid 4 hours, the police finally show up and, well, that goes about as well as you can expect.
Come out with your hands up. We have you surrounded. There's nowhere to run.
Sir, that's not what we're here for.
Oh. Can I kick down the door at least?
Of course.
Wow. This place is a dump. Oh, thank goodness you're finally... Oh my gosh, it's the criminals! Put your hands up!
Kids? Put your hands up.
Smoothies! Get them while they're...
cold.
You might think I'm exaggerating. Maybe I am a little. But if you've ever dealt with small-town cops, you know exactly what I'm talking about. Well, anyways, they proceed to take all of our statements, and that goes well, I guess.
Blah, blah, mm-hmm. blah, blah.
You don't
blah,
say. Blah, hmm. blah, oh, blah, that's blah, terrible. Blah, blah, seen it before. Blah, blah. Oh, ouch. Wait a minute! What? You figured something out? Yeah! You guys were robbed! Did you know that? That's what I've been telling you about for the past 30 minutes!
That's not what my notes say. That's not what my notes say at all.
So, what are you guys gonna do?
Nothing.
What? Wrap it up, boys! We're out of here! And that was it. We never saw our stuff again. But now we get to the juicy part of the story. Cage. Cage was a mystery, for sure. We were in the same grade, but he was much, much older. Held back a few times because of behavioral issues. And while, of course, I changed his name, this was the closest name I could come up with that is almost as scary as his real name. This kid, or I guess he was actually a teen while the rest of us were kids, not sure how they allowed that to happen, was a nightmare. And I can remember meeting him like it was yesterday. Now, my mom, who's been pretty suspicious of everyone and everything since we got back, tells our dad at like 10 p.m. one night that she saw someone in our yard. So our dad goes outside with a rake. I wasn't exactly sure what his plan was, but he goes outside and starts yelling, "Hey, who's there?" while madly swinging around the rake to show he means business. But then a small pasty kid just popped out of nowhere. So my dad, obviously confused, asks the kid what he's doing, and the kid replies, "I'm hunting bunny rabbits."
Bunny rabbits?
You'd be the perfect friend for my sons.
What? My sons! They don't have any friends! Wanna be their friend? Okay. Hey guys, I made a friend for you.
Oh no. Not again.
And it all pretty much went downhill from there. Cage was that friend that you just knew within 5 minutes of meeting him that he'd be a bad influence. Now, I don't want to toot my own horn. I don't even have a horn. But I was a good noodle. A quiet, hardworking, emotionally sensitive 12-year-old. Cage was... not.
What the?
Hey, Attaboy! You wanna go steal some bikes? But I already have a bike. Two would be nice. I don't know what I would do with two bikes. Alright. Wanna go light some stuff on fire? Not only would he regularly commit multiple crimes like steal bikes, vandalize the park, or get his older deadbeat brother to beat up his enemies, this guy was straight up crazy. One day, he decided to get his ears pierced. But does he go to the shop to get his ears pierced? No! This guy casually manhandles a stapler and staples his earlobe! I kid you not. And this was during class too, so the teacher is just sitting there like... That's the kind of demon that Cage was. Drove people nuts! I still get nightmares. And not only that, but I happen to know for a fact that he was the kid who robbed our house. His mean gang of hooligan friends even told us one day that they used to break into houses for fun. Now I know what you're thinking. Attaboy, all this doesn't really prove he did it now, does it? Sure, his friends told you they would rob houses before, including the very house you lived in. But hey, if that's all that I have as evidence, then I'd be inclined to agree with you. Except...
Hey, nice truck, Cage. Wow, where'd you get all that new stuff? Oh, my granny died, so we got a lot of inheritance. Wow, I used to have a sofa just like that one. But it was stolen. Yeah, weird, right? And that TV! Looks like the one that I had. Uh-huh. And is that a piece of the Berlin Wall? Wow, my dad was there when it fell. I think he had a piece like that. Hey, wait a minute! You've got great taste. So you tell me.
Hey guys, thanks for watching the video.
How about you all? Ever make a friend you regret making? Let me know in the comments below. I'd love to hear your funny, or tragic, stories. Anyways, I'll see you guys in the next one.